evening and thank you for viewing this virtual 8th grade promotion ceremony. My name is Nerma Krupich, National Junior Honor Society President. I will be the master of ceremony tonight. At this time, Jenna Valavini, Marco Mlinar, Carson Tucker, Reed Valancourt, and Brody Rollins of NJHS and Student Council will now recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge of allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic
for which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
I would like to introduce the Laconia School Board members and the Laconia School District personnel in attendance today. Aaron Hayward, School Board Member. Don Johnson, School Board Member. Mal Murray, School Board Member. Robert Champlin, School Board Member. Heather Lounsbury, School Board Chairperson. Laura Dunn, School Board Member. Nick Grennan, School Board Member. Stephen Tucker, Superintendent. Amy Hines, Assistant Superintendent. Dr. Allison Bryant, Laconia Middle School Principal. Kelly O'Brien, Laconia Middle School Assistant Principal. Angel Burke, Laconia Middle School Academic Coordinator of Teaching and Learning. Jennifer Sawtak, Laconia Middle School Student Service Coordinator. Good evening, everyone. I would like to welcome all of you to this virtual promotion ceremony. It seems like just yesterday, me and my classmates were walking through the doors at Laconia Middle School, scared and excited for our first day of sixth grade. The staff welcomed us that day with open arms and have continued to support us throughout the 3 years that we've spent here. My classmates and I are incredibly grateful for all that the staff at Laconia Middle School has done for us so that we can have a great middle school experience. We would also like to thank all of the family members that helped us through our time here at the middle school. With all that has been going on in the world lately, we did not get to experience the typical 8th grade year. But we've made the best of our situation. Remote learning has been a challenge. We've never done anything like this before. Being separated from each other has been hard for all of us, but we will be able to learn together again soon. This fall, we will begin the next 4 years of our journey. Although high school will be a new and different adventure for all of us, I know we will have amazing experiences, do wonderful things, and make lifelong memories. Thank you and congratulations. Dr. Allison Bryant will now present her principal's address.
Good evening, 8th grade students, family, staff, and community. My name is Dr. Bryant, and I'm the principal of Laconia Middle School. It is an honor to speak to you tonight. And although circumstances out of our control require that our ceremony is remote, we stand together tonight to celebrate the accomplishments of this class in this important ceremony, which is the doorway between middle school and high school. We are in the midst of a defining moment in this world's history. Your stories and experiences from the past few months will go down in a collective history, but this moment alone does not define you. You are brave students, and you have taken on challenges with determination far before remote learning was a thing. What you have learned from this time will serve you well in your future. There's a famous piece of writing called "All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten." Here's a condensed version of this piece. All I really need to know about how to live and what to do and how to be, I learned in kindergarten. Wisdom is not at the top of the graduate school mountain, but there in the sand pile. These are the things I learned. Share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people. Put things back where you found them. Clean up your own mess. Don't take things that aren't yours. Say you're sorry when you hurt somebody. Wash your hands before you eat. Live a balanced life. Learn some and think some, and draw and paint and sing and dance and play and work every day some. When you go out into the world, watch out for traffic. Stick together. Be aware of wonder. This piece was written 20 years ago, and maybe you recognize it because it's often quoted on posters and signs. But now is your time. If I had to guess what you've learned during these past few months, I think it might sound something like this. All I really needed to know, I learned during remote learning. Make sure you have a full charge, but know when to unplug. Nothing takes the place of face-to-face interaction. It's important to check in with the people you care about and the people who care about you. Know when to be silent or hit the mute button. Know when to speak up. Wash your hands. Look for the beauty around you. Be creative. Approach challenges from new angles. The most important thing is to keep learning however you can, whenever you can, wherever you can. And finally, to fit with the theme of tonight's promotion, I encourage you to consider these truths from Skywalker, Yoda, and Obi-Wan Kenobi. You can't stop change any more than you can stop the suns from setting. To reach our goal, a straight line we will not follow. Many of the truths that we cling to depend greatly on our point of view. This class will always have a special place in Laconia Middle School's history, in the history of our city, and in the history of our world. The joy that you have brought to us and the brightness of your future is immeasurable. Tonight, I will release you from your roles as eighth grade students, and we will promote you to high school. You will become Laconia School District's freshman class. Take care of each other. Continue to step up and support each other in doing so. Be courageous. This is a new day, a new beginning, and it belongs to you. Congratulations. The Principal's Award recognizes students who have shown growth and leadership skills during their time at Laconia Middle School. This year, there are two recipients of the Principal's Award. The first Principal's Award goes to a student who consistently demonstrates kindness and service to others. He is a role model for younger students in the building, particularly in his role as mentor for sixth grade students. It is my honor to present this award to Perrin Drolet. The second Principal's Award goes to a student who also is a role model of kindness and positivity. She demonstrates gratitude for educational opportunities, and she stands up for what is right. It is my honor to present this Principal's Award to Ashlyn Dunn. The Remote Learning Champion Award is a new award given this year to a student who has demonstrated leadership and dedication to our school community during this time of remote learning. For more than 50 consecutive remote learning school days, this student has risen to the challenge of providing his school community with important information and always with a smile. It is my honor to present the Remote Learning Champion Award to Uzziah Bright.
We will now recognize the eighth graders that have demonstrated academic excellence. I would like to recognize our 14 top achieving students: Renee Bergeron, Kathleen Carmignani, Joey Lynn Corson, Perrin Drulay, James Horan, Rowan Jones, Nirma Kuprick, Lacey Linkola, Emma Morrill, Alex Richardson, Brody Rollins, Alicia Sakurai, Carson Tucker, and Kerrigan Williams. These students have all maintained a career GPA of 4.0 from the time they started sixth grade to the time they finished eighth. Congratulations.
The Director's Award for Band is presented to one student who has demonstrated exemplary character, leadership, musicianship, and dedication to our band. This year, I could not do that, as there were two students who have equally earned this honor. Both students have taken private lessons on their main instrument and even studied a second instrument independent of my asking. Above and beyond the call of duty, they participated in the Solo and Ensemble Festival, the Lakes Region Music Festival, and our own LMS jazz band, frequently as soloists, as well as community ensembles outside of our school. Every time they could, they ate lunch in the band room so they could practice together, explore and sight read new music, and sometimes even write their own. Thank you, James Horan and Alex Richardson, for all you have contributed to our program. You are the 2020 recipients of the Director's Award for Band.
Hello, 8th graders. So I have three awards to give out. The first is the Most Improved Award. This student has been in chorus for 3 years now. This student has shown a lot of improvement and a lot of enthusiasm over the course of these 3 years, and I'm very, very happy to award this to Miss Jacqueline Murgatroy. The second award I have is the Chorus Excellence Award. This student, again, has been in chorus for all 3 years. They have shown a ton of enthusiasm. They're always in class singing and dancing and smiling and showing so much energy for what we do in class. And I think everyone would agree that this person is the most enthusiastic person in all parts of their life. So I'm very pleased to award the Chorus Excellence Award to Mr. Uzziah Bright. And finally, the last award I have is the Chorus Directors Award. This student shows a lot of leadership in chorus. They have been a section leader. They have gone to Lakes Region. They've done a ton of festivals. They are constantly improving themselves and their craft in chorus. And I'm so happy and so pleased to award this award to Miss Emma Morell.
I'm very pleased to award the following students certificates for excellence in Spanish: DeMorne Cooper, Rowan Jones, Lacey Linkola, Alisa Sacleroy, and Kerrigan Williams. The Spanish award goes to the student with the highest grade point average for the 2 years of Spanish 1. The Spanish award is awarded to Carson Tucker. I'm very pleased to present the following students certificates for excellence in French: Rene Bergeron, Perrin Drolet, James Horan, Marco Milner, and Brody Rollins. The French award goes to the student with the highest grade point average over the 2 years for French 1. The French award is awarded to Katie Carmignani. Felicitations and felicitaciones.
Hi, my name is Carrie Duhamel. I'm the special ed teacher on the OPG team. I'll be presenting the Most Improved Award for the OPG team. This student has made huge improvements over the course of this school year. He not only has grown as a student, but he has grown as a person. He has rose to the challenge of remote learning and has strived. His perseverance and hard work has shown through his success. We know with these skills that he will do well in high school and in years to come. This year's Most Improved Award goes to Holden Bredo. It's been a pleasure having you as a student, and we are so proud of you and your achievements. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Shannon Siegler, the OPG ELA teacher. This year's English Award goes to a student who is an avid reader, one who makes connections between the things she reads and the world around her. She is very thoughtful, insightful, and asks great thought-provoking questions, and is not afraid to go out and seek answers to them. She works very hard on her skills, looks for feedback, and is not afraid to take intellectual risks. Her writing is strong and contains great voice and is always a delight to read. This year's award goes to Ms. Emma Morrell. Congratulations.
Greetings and congratulations to the class of 2024. My name is Christopher Carey, and it is my privilege to present the OPG Math Award to a student who throughout the entire year has consistently excelled, not only with their grades, but with their ability to help other students and their ability to explain things both to me and their fellow peers. So this year's 2020 OPG Math Award goes to Kerrigan Williams. Congratulations, Kerrigan.
Good evening. My name is Jessica Rominger, and I'm a science teacher on Team OPG. When asking myself who of my students deserves recognition for their work in the science classroom, I think about who has demonstrated skills that a scientist would want to have. This means that this person will be curious, will be patient, will be persistent, will be open-minded, and be a good problem solver. This year, I have chosen James Horan to be the OPG Science Scholar. James, I'm confident that these skills will take you very far, and I'm really proud of the work that you've done this year. I can't wait to hear about your future endeavors at high school, and I thank you for a really fun and engaging year of learning.
It is with great honor that I get to present this year's 2020 Social Studies Award for Team OPG. The student who has won this award is someone who has been consistently recognized by all of his teachers as someone who not only pushes himself, but pushes his teachers to become better learners. This individual throughout the year has asked amazing questions, has written thoughtful answers, and has always been a joy to be in class. So the 2020 OPG Social Studies Award goes to Carson Tucker. Congratulations, Carson.
This year, for Team Winnisquam, the Most Improved Award goes to a young man who at the beginning of the year was much like the nutty professor. By the end of the year, this young man was striving for and achieving A's. He was much more organized and always reached out to his teachers for help. This year's Most Improved Award goes to Drayden Perino. Congratulations, Drayden.
Time to announce the Excellence in Language Arts Award. This goes out yearly to a student who not only demonstrates excellence grade-wise, but also a student who is dedicated to reading, to writing, who is willing to take criticism and always has a willingness to be better. I am honored to say that this year's winner of the Language Arts Award is Joey Corson. Congrats, Joey.
This year's Team Winnisquam Math Excellence Award goes to a hardworking student who's always pushing herself to excel. She's a role model in the classroom, does exemplary math work, and was always willing to lend a helping hand to her classmates. This year's award goes to Audrey Dunleavy. Congratulations, Audrey. And congratulations to the rest of the 2024 class for a great school year.
For those of you watching at home, I am Leanne Keller, the science teacher for Team Winnisquam. Every year when I start thinking about the Winnisquam Science Award, I think about students who show curiosity and perseverance, as well as pride in their academic success. This year, Marco Milinar exhibited all of these qualities. Marco, you pushed yourself to achieve academic excellence and expected and fostered excellence in your classmates. You were kind and gracious in any group you were asked to join, and always respectful when you had a question or needed to advocate for yourself. For all of these reasons, you are the 2020 Winnisquam Science Award recipient. Thank you.
The Excellence in Social Studies Award for Team Winnisquam is going to a student who is committed to his studies, engaging deeply with the material we studied. He was always looking for ways to improve his work and was an excellent class participant. He was also a leader in the classroom, quietly modeling dedication, self-direction, and a positive attitude. It is my pleasure to present this award to Perrin Drolet.
The Martin Harwood Award. This award is given in memory of Martin Harwood, a longtime teacher and principal at Laconia Memorial Middle School. Mr. Harwood was the moving force behind establishing team teaching here in Laconia. In his 30 plus years in education, he never missed a day of school. The Martin E. Harwood Award is given each year by the faculty to an eighth grade student who has demonstrated high academic achievement, dedicated school service, and commendable personal values, all of the qualities exhibited by Mr. Harwood during his years in education. This year's Harwood Award recipients are Lacey Linkola and Nirma Kuprick.
The Douglas A. Whittem Award. Douglas Whittem was a longtime educator in the city of Laconia, with the majority of his years spent at the middle school level. Whittem served in a variety of educational positions during his 49-plus years in the Laconia school system: teacher, guidance counselor, department head, special education coordinator, assistant principal, and principal. He was well known for his unique sense of humor and his compassion for students. The Douglas A. Whittem Award is given each year by the faculty to two 8th grade students whose presence, actions, and excellence of character have had a positive impact on his and her peers here at Laconia Middle School. This year's Douglas A. Whittem Award recipients are Reed Valancourt and Emily Gagnon.
I will now present the Jason Sharlin Athlete Award. Jason Sharlin was the son of Joseph Red Sharlin, a longtime teacher and coach here at the middle school. Jason's life was sadly cut short by cancer. During his time here at the middle school, Jason consistently demonstrated the qualities of outstanding citizenship and sportsmanship, as well as academic excellence. This award is given by faculty each year in memory of Jason to two 8th grade students who have consistently demonstrated the above-mentioned qualities exhibited by Jason: outstanding citizenship, outstanding sportsmanship, and academic excellence. This year's Jason Sharlin Student Award recipients are Nirma Kuprick and Rowan Jones. Congratulations, Nirma and Rowan.
Hello and good evening to all. Congratulations to the Laconia Middle School Class of 2020. Tonight, I am here to present the Nuka Scholar Athlete Award. The Nuka Scholar Athlete Award has been presented at 8th grade promotion night since 1996. About the award itself: the folks that this is named for were educators here in Laconia for many years. Mr. Nukas, my dad, came to Laconia in 1946 to be a history teacher and basketball coach. As time went on, he moved to the position of physical educator and then vice principal at Laconia High School. In the early 1960s, a new junior high was built on this same lot, and my father was chosen to be the first principal. In the late 60s, my dad moved on to Manchester, New Hampshire, where he ultimately retired as assistant superintendent of schools. My mother, also an educator, starting here in Laconia as an elementary school teacher and eventually moving to Manchester area with my dad. As retirement rolled around for both of them, they moved back to Laconia and spent the rest of their years here. No matter where their life would lead, my folks would always return to their home in Laconia. Because of their love for athletics, while also knowing how important the academics were, our family established this award to honor their memory and hard work and dedication to the youth of Laconia. The Nuka Scholar Athlete Award is presented each year to two outstanding students, one boy and one girl, who excel in the classroom, while also participating in numerous athletic programs, and also being aware of the world around them, trying to make it a better place. We also look for someone who is well respected by his peers and the adults in his 3 years here at Laconia Middle School. The young lady selected this year is an officer in your student council, as well as National Junior Honor Society. She maintained a near perfect GPA and participated in cross country in the fall and softball in the spring. It is with great pleasure I present the Nuka Scholar Athlete Award to Jenna Valvani. The young man receiving the Nuka Award tonight is also an officer in student council, as well as NJHS. Athletically, he participated in soccer, football, basketball, and baseball. Academically, he was also top in his class. It is with extreme pleasure we present the Nuka Scholar Athlete Award to Carson Tucker.
Emma Morrell, National Junior Honor Society parliamentarian and student council officer, will now be doing the closing speech.
I would like to start off by thanking all of the teachers and staff who have not only supported us through the last 3 years of our lives, but have also done an amazing job of working through the current circumstances. You handled the transition into remote learning wonderfully and put together this unique way of ending our years here at Laconia Middle School. Thank you for always having us in your minds and hearts. Now, students, although we all knew that this day would come, it seemed so distant at the beginning of sixth grade. I never imagined it would feel so fast. Looking back, it feels like our first day of sixth grade was so recent, but it has actually been 3 very eventful years full of laughter, lessons, tears, and memories. We have grown many strong friendships while allowing some to end. I'm sure many of you, including myself, have made some mistakes throughout these years. Those mistakes are just lessons that make us stronger and wiser. As we conclude our middle school years, not all of us will move on to Laconia High School together. As I part from Laconia School District, it is tremendously sad to say goodbye to the people who have shaped me to be the person I am today, since kindergarten all the way up to this day. I am grateful for all of you. You have helped me build a strong foundation that will support me wherever life brings me in the future. I am also disappointed that I never got to say one last thank you to all of the teachers that have gotten us to where we are today. You dedicated your time and got so little appreciation for everything that you did. Truly, you are influencing a better future. The past 3 years of our lives have certainly not been the easiest, but we made it. When I was a little first grader, I couldn't wait to go to high school and get a driver's license and go off to college. But now, quite frankly, I'm terrified. But we've already made it this far, so I have no doubt that you will all go on to do amazing things. With the pressure to have a successful future, sometimes it can be hard to keep sight of what you really want. So as we adventure off into high school, use these next 4 years of your lives to explore what really makes you happy. If you choose a job that you love, you will never have to work a day in your life. Though our years at Laconia Middle School are concluding, the memories will live forever. When we're all grown up, we can tell our children and grandchildren not only about the toilet paper panic of 2020, but also about the awkward school dances, chaotic bus rides, middle school drama, and the interesting dance trends. We may also share the academic and life lessons that we have received. As stressful as it may seem, we are the future, and it is our job to fix the problems that we are discovering with our world. Our generation has more power than any before us, with new technology being invented every day. Each one of you has so much potential to change our world and our society. Sadly, everything must come to an end, and as we've learned, change is not easy, but it is very much possible. I wish you all the best of luck in the coming future. Stay safe and wash your hands. With great honor, I present to you the class of 2024.
Congratulations on graduating from Laconia Middle School. You guys are awesome. I'm going to miss you all, especially my 8th grade Maple team members who would come and visit me after school to get candy out of the candy box that nobody told Dr. Brian about. Shh. I'm going to miss seeing you. Please make sure you come and visit on to Laconia High School, where you guys get to write your own next chapter. You get to chase whatever future it is you want. So work hard, stay strong, be positive. You've got this. Congratulations, 8th grade.
Your job's a joke, you broke, your love life's DOA. It's like you're always stuck in second gear, when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year. But I'll be there for you.
Guys, congratulations. It's been awesome being your teacher this year. We've had quite a ride. Good luck on your next adventure.
Your mother warned you there'd be days like these, but she didn't tell you when the world's brought you down to your knees. And I'll be there for you.
This is Miss Sue Hamill here. I just wanted to wish you guys a good summer and good luck in high school. You guys have done great. I know this is not how you wanted to finish off your middle school career, but you've achieved great things and you guys have done well with remote learning. I know you'll do great next year in high school. And again, I just wanted to wish you good luck and have a great summer.
I will remember. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for the memory.
Team Winnesquam, who knew when we started the school year that we would be ending this way? But so many of you worked so hard during this time of remote learning, and I am so proud of you. You're going to go to Laconia High School, and you're going to do great things. So remember to be kind, be yourselves, and be awesome. Winnesquam, Keller out.
Standing on the edge of something much too deep. Funny how it feels so much, I cannot say a word. We are screaming inside.
Say thank you to all of you for being such a great class and making the first semester so much fun. I learned a lot from you guys, and I hope you learned a lot from me, and good luck next year in high school.
First off, congratulations on making it through this difficult and unpredictable year. I just wanted to thank you all for two things. First, thank you for helping me with my education as I work towards becoming a full-time teacher. I appreciate your kindness and your patience as we spent time together. And I want to thank you, secondly, and most importantly, for allowing me to be a part of your journey through, this school year. It was really special, and I really enjoyed the time we got to spend together in class and a little less so, but on Google Classroom as well. So I hope that, we'll see each other in the future, and congratulations again, and take care.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Who knew all the planes we flew, good things we've been through, then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays.
Hello, 8th graders, this is Mr. Carey, and I just wanted to congratulate you all for conquering one of the most crazy years of teaching and learning that I've ever been a part of. This, without a doubt, shows us that you will be able to conquer anything that is thrown your way. So, as you go off to the high school, I'd like to congratulate you, the class of 2024. Best of luck.
You win a better place. You win a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
We started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
First you both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our
when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side, and now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It was
1980
something when I graduated from the then called the Memorial Middle School, and I don't remember it all that well. I think you guys are going to remember this one, and we'll remember for you. It was nice to walk beside you on this journey. Best of-
cannot believe how resilient you have been this year. You have tackled so many things, so many historic things, and I cannot wish you the best. Always remember, I will always be part of your world. You will never be by yourself, and one day we will always be out there together. I wish you the best. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2024.
I am proud of your hard work this year and your perseverance to hang strong during one of the most wild years in recent history. I wish you luck on the next part of your journey, and I hope you enjoy high school.
Congratulations, 8th grade. You made it to the end of the year. It was a little tough, but you guys persevered and you got through it. And here we are. You guys are promoting to high school. It's hard to believe that you will not be returning next year to Laconia Middle School, but know that we will miss you. I'm especially going to miss my Real Initiative students and my student leadership team. I know I can speak for both myself and Miss Gingerella when I say the best part of our day is getting to spend it with you guys. So enjoy your summer, enjoy next year. Remember, you can do anything if you put your mind to it, and stay positive. All right?
Hi guys, it's Miss Siegs. We learned a lot of lessons this school year. I think big ones for me were about change and choice. Certainly, I would not have chosen the change to the end of this school year, but I did learn a lot about that I had the power to choose the way I would respond to challenges brought on by change. Some changes are great though. You're headed off to high school, and I'm so excited for you. Please remember that you have the power to make choices, and that you have the power to decide that you want to make a different choice. So if you head down a path in life and for whatever reason you decide it's no longer for you, you have the power to stop, do some reflecting, and turn around or head off into a different direction. I wish you much good luck and nothing but the best in your future. It has been my pleasure to work with you this year.